Classification of the phylum Echinodermata. Echinodermata is divided into two subphyla. They are Palmatozoa and Elytrozoa. These are the two subphyla are found in the phylum Echinodermata. The main differences between the Palmatozoa and Elytrozoa are, one is the Palmatozoa's main characters are, these are sessile. They do not move from one place to other place, just like a plants. They are attached to the substratum in the water. And they have stalk also. There is a stalk is present. With the help of the stalk, it is attached to the substratum. For example, you can see this diagram here. Cirrhae is present here. With the help of cirrhae, it is attached to the substratum. That's why they are sessile animals or sedentary animals. But a few are free living forms are also found in this subphyla. And mouth. Mouth, anus is present at the upper surface, on the upper surface of the body, mouth as well as anus, both are present at one side. Here you can see the diagram here, mouth is present and behind that there is a anus is present. These two are present at the same side, that is upper side of the body or upper surface. And madreporite is absent, no madreporite is present in the Palmatozoa. Madreporite main function is the, in the water vascular system, sea water is enters into the body through the madreporite, but it is absent here. And umbilical grooves are also related to the water vascular system. These umbilical grooves are open here. These are the main characters of the Palmatozoa. Now we have to discuss the Elytrozoa characters are also. Before that, we have to discuss the Palmatozoa. Palmatozoa includes only one class. Only one class is present in the Palmatozoa, that is known as the Crinoidea. Crinoidea. These animals are commonly known as sea lilies. They are commonly known as, this is the diagram, it looks like the sea lily. Hence, it is found in the marine water, hence they are known as the sea lilies is the common name. Sometimes these are also known as the feather stars. They are also known as the feather stars. These are the common names of the Crinoidea. Hence, these are the oldest animals in the phylum Echinodermata. They are oldest animals and also most primitive forms. When compared to other classes, the primitive characters are present in this class, hence they are known as the oldest animals and most primitive forms are found in the class Crinoidea. And theca, there is a bag-like structure is also present here. This is the viscera. Viscera means the important organs of the body are present inside, that is known as the viscera. This viscera is enclosed in a calcareous chest. All the important organs of the digestive system, other systems are covered by a calcareous chest, bag-like structure, that is known as the theca. Theca is present here. And arms. These arms are biramous and bear pinnules. They help in food capture. For example, you can see here, these are the arms. Usually, there are five arms are present in echinoderms, but arms are biramous. Each arm is again divided into two. One like that, these are divided into two like that. His arms are not single, they are biramous, they are divided into two and bear pinnules. These are the small hair-like structures are present on the body, they are known as the pinnules. They are flexible also and smooth also. These are all help in the food capture. In the marine water, there are large number of food particles are present. As with the help of the pinnules of the arms, they catch the food. It is indirectly useful for food capturing. That is the function of the pinnules which are present on the arms. And development. Yes, already we have discussed in the gender characters of the echinodermata. There are different types of larval forms are found in the echinodermata. For example, in crinoidea, development is indirect, the presence of larval forms. Yes, but here in this class, there are two types of larval forms are present. One is the dolioleria larva. Sometimes pentacrinoidea larva is also present. These are the two larval forms are present in some animals. This is the special characters of the class crinoidea. The examples are neometra. Yes, this is commonly known as the feather star. This is commonly known as feather star and pentacrines. This is known as the sea lilies. That's why these class animals are commonly known as sea lilies. And another example is the antidon. This is the diagram of the antidon. Yes, it is sedentary animal, sessile animal found in the marine water. With the help of the cirri, it is attached to the substratum. And here arms are present, arms are biramous and pinnules are also present. It looks like a flower or lily. Hence, these animals are commonly known as the sea lilies. Yes, next. Elytrozoa subphylum. This Elytrozoa subphylum is divided into four classes. They are Osteroidea, example is the Osterius, and Ophiuroidea, they are known as the Ophiothrix. Here is the, they looks like a star, hence they are known as the starfishes. And it looks like their arms are, look like say snake tail, hence they are known as serpent tail animals. They are known as the Ophiothrix example. Echinoidea example is Echinus. They are round shape, no arms are present. That's why they are commonly known as sea dollars or sea urchins. And Holothuroidea, another class including the Elytrozoa, example is the Holothuria. And here arms are present. They are found in the marine water. Body is elongated and resembles to cucumber. Hence, they are known as the sea cucumbers. Now, we have to discuss the main characters of the subphylum Elytrozoa and the general characters of the all these classes we have to discuss now.